Worse luck for me.
He's getting to be a rather rich man, isn't he, Jerry?
Yes, this rather dashes our chances of scooping up the half a million to ourselves, doesn't it?
Possibly.
Whatever am I going to do?
Well, you could get a job.
I'm sorry?
You know, work.
Work? Jackie, please, don't be disgusting. Good lordy. Work? Me? Disgrace the family name? Get up before noon? Why, you must be off your chump. There must be better ways of raising money than that.
Well, you could try selling this.
But Jackie, that's our engagement ring.
Sorry, darling. I can't afford to mix business with pleasure. If our new Lord Halford is going to get the money, then I'm going to get the new Lord Halford.
Well, you've barely got and broken my very heart, and I hope you are satisfied. I...
We should talk later.
Who is he and where is he?
Hey.
Good afternoon, Sir Jasper. Ready? Mr. Porchester. Be seated. Where is Sir John?
I passed him in the hallway. He's trying to get over the dreadful shock we've all had.
Damn it all, Maria. Those poodles take an unhealthy interest in my ankles.
But you're late, John.
Yes, come on higher.
Sit down.
Yes.
Well, now that we're all gathered, Mr. Porchester has some news, and it will affect all of us.
Your Grace, Your Grace. Now, you will all be aware that the last Lord Halford in his youth contracted a most unfortunate marriage with a most unsuitable young lady.
Yes, sir.
Now, they soon parted, and she died. There were rumors of a son, however, and the late Lord Hartford's will had to provide for the possibility of his one day turning up.
Yeah.
I have to tell you all that it is quite certain that he has turned up.
Good Lord, so there is a new Lord Hartford.
Most assuredly, Sir John. However, it is not quite as simple as all that. You see, the will insists that the heir be a person fit and proper to assume his place here.
Yes, but how do we decide whether he is fit and proper?
Well, the two executors of the will must decide, Gerald, Her Grace and Sir John.
Well, then, what sort of cricketer is he?
Here.
Well, then, let's have a look at him. Ring the bell, Gerald.
But before he is introduced to you all,
I should... Get on with it, Boxchester!
Bravo!
Hey!
Here, Breeze, come along!
Yes, we're all absolute tenderhooks. My love.
Frederick.
My lamb.
Shut up.
But I feel I should tell you all that his new lordship is not what you expect. He is rather...
Oh, damn it all, Parchester. Never knew such a one for talk.
Eh?
Well, Parchester, what's he called, the new earl?
William is his first name, Lady Jacqueline.
William?
Show the gentleman in now, please.
Does he yet know who the earl is?
No, I felt it should be broken to him gently.
He would like to come this way, sir.
Oh, you would?
Welcome to Hereford, William.
Cheers, Squire.
May I present Her Grace, the Duchess of Den.
Nice to meet you, lady. Very nice indeed.
May I present an old friend of the family, Sir John Trelane.
What's the old Parker?
Oh, good Lord.
My daughter, Lady Jacqueline Costello.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Hello,
nice to meet you.
Yes, very nice indeed. Very nice and all.
Say, my nephew, General Bolingbroke.
How do you do? Oh, sorry, I dropped my cigarette in your drink here.
How disgusting! Good and native Battersby.
How are you?
How do you do?
Nice to meet you, old China.
Perhaps you'd like the drink?
Rather!
Here. Oh, my God, that decanter is over 200 years old.
Thank God for that. It could have been a new one.
Righto. Perhaps lighter.
That's right. You tell him, darling. A bit of a lad, is he?
Mr. Colchester, you old man.
Right.
And this is Sir Jasper Treat.
Hey, who's that?
I'm very pleased to meet you, sunshine. My mates call me Bill.
Thank you.
Shall we proceed, Your Grace?
Yes. Please sit down.
Oh, very much. Thank you very much. Thank
you. Now, before we tell you why you are here, we'd like to know something about you, William.
Where do you live?
I live in a distant village called London.
But what part?
All of me.
What part of London is that?
Lambeth.
What is Lambeth?
It's the best part of London, Squire. Just south of Brixton, just north of Waterloo.
House or a flat?
I got a parlor, drawing room, dining room, kitchen, bathroom, bedroom, all in the same room. About the size of that fireplace over there. The boss in the sink. The first day you bought the top part, second day you bought the middle part, third day you bought...
And what do you live on?
No, me wits.
Well, you must be severely undernourished. Now, what is it that you actually do?
Do? Why, I do anything, Squire. I do a bit of sparring now and again. You know, run for a bookie, sell fruit on a barrel. Holly, holly, all fresh ripe strawberries. And I do a bit. Go on, sir, pick a card now. Go on. Do I know this man? No, I do not know this man. Go on, sir. Now tell me what it is, please.
Five of spades.
Correct. The man wins a silver watch.
What? This is my watch. He's lifting my watch. Now, let's just get on with
it. Now, William, we have a surprise for you.
Oh, yeah.
Rochester.
Yes. Do you know anything about your parents, William?
The brown bread.
Brown bread?
What are you talking about, brown bread?
Well, I said brown bread. Dead.
Oh, it's Cockney rhyming slang. I say, can you do that?
Rhyming slang?
Yes, the old time at the racetrack. It's not even two.
Are you trying to tell us that your parents are dead, William?
Well, I said, brown bread, snuffed it. That is, if I had any parents, because I think it was spontaneous. You know what I mean?
Not quite. Yeah. The facts are these. Your late father was the Earl of Hereford, and you are his only son.
Oh.
Therefore, William, Alexander, Bradford, Charles, Augustus, Prestine, Snibson, you are by right and lawful succession, the 18th Baron Haberlingland, High Steward of the Brandyston Estuary, Marshal Royal in Ordinary to the Marquisate of Snetterton, and the 14th Earl of Hereford!
Get away, you're pulling on my tinkler, ain't you?
Nothing could be more serious.
Oh, God.
Oh,
Lord has fainted. Quick, water.
Yeah, I didn't faint for water.
Brandy!
That's right. Thanks, cheers.
Oh!
Cheers, what?
Oh, Father, the 13th Earl was my brother. You may therefore refer to me as your Aunt Mariah. Jacqueline and Gerald are your cousins.
My family? What him? Nice to meet you, Uncle Johnny.
Uncle John?
Well, ain't you and the Duchess Mary now?
Oh, good heavens, no.
Now, me and Nob, a belted earl.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, does that mean I've got a lot of bees now?
I'm sorry?
Bees and honey. Money.
Oh, you have about 100,000 pounds.
Oh, that's not bad, is
a
it?
A year.
Oh, bloody hell. Dear, well, I'll just take this year's installment and be off then.
I'm afraid it's not as simple as all that.
You're not allowed to touch the inheritance.
How much?
The money, unless the executors of your father's will, Sir John here and myself, are agreed that you are a fit and proper person to stay on here as master of the airport. Otherwise, you will receive an annuity to live in retirement.
Fit and proper? Yes. Me? For you lot? Forget it, forget it.
Come on, look at this. I will educate you, and I am confident that you will learn to rule the airport.
Impossible! You can't make a silk purse out of a sow's ear.
William, I am going to make you into a gentleman. If you do as I bid you, blood will tell.
If you don't, blood will flow.
There have been Harefoots here as lords of the manor for 700 years. You are the last of the line. You will stay here and perpetuate the family.
Perpetuate?
Yes. Struth. And instead of one room, why, you will have 100 and 12 bathrooms.
Ooh, wait till I show this lord to my Sally.
Sally?
Yeah, she's my girl. She and I'm gonna love all this.
I should mention, William, that it is a condition of your father's will that you marry a fit and proper wife.
Well, that's all right, because Sally's fit and proper me. I brought her with me in the car. Fetch her in.
Don't do that.
All right, John, take it easy. Take it easy. There you go. You watch now.
What is that?
The will states that you must marry someone of your own class.
Well, that's all right, because Sally is my own class.
Not any longer. You may bring her in, but tell her who you really are. Then I shall have the car take her away to Lambeth.
Well, we'll just see about that, me old fruit.
Oh, I can just see the newspaper headlines. Hoffman's Cockney Lord, fish and chips in the library. Mariah, you can't let him take over this house.
But it's his heritage, and he was born to be an earl.
Yes, but Mariah, who was brought up to be an idler, a wastrel, and a layabout.
And what? Is the difference.
Girlfriend will be like.
John, if our king chooses to abdicate for some colonial woman, that's one thing. I'm not allowing a member of our family to do the same.
Well, yes, but then what are we to do?
Well, Mr. Porchester, he's here to advise.
Yes, Mr. Porchester, please do advise.
As the family solicitor, here's my advice to you. As the family solicitor, here's what you ought to do. For 6 and 8, I'll put you straight if anything goes wrong. For I contend you must defend, and life is one sweet song. So sing a little and dance a little, be gay a little and play a little. Bring your troubles more and more to the family solicitor. Hop a little and skip a little and jump a little and rip a little. Hang your lucky stars once more for the family, the family, the family's a listener.
Bring your troubles more and more to family solicitor. little and rip a little. Thank your lucky stars once more for the family solicitor.
Up a little and skip a little and jump a little and rip a little. Thank your lucky stars once more for the family solicitor.
Done. Maria must be stopped. I want that man out of this house.
Well, we could take a look at the family will.
See if we can find some way out.
Yes.
Some loophole.
Yes, sir.
Where's the will?
In the library.
Well,
library.
What are we waiting for?
Library! Library!
Wait for me!
It's all right. They've all gone. Open your eyes and clock this. Care to dine with me, Miss Smith?
Oh, Bill, it's huge! It's bigger than the British Museum!
Clean and all, you could eat your dinner off that floor.
Well, you don't have to. They even have posh newspaper to eat your chips out of.
Here, Sal, look at the size of this vinegar bottle.
Bill, I still can't believe it.
It's true, Sal. Me aunt's a duchess. You know what that makes me?
Dutch.
Nah, I'm one of them. I'm a lord.
And this is your house?
My house? Well, our house. Here. Here. I know, not very homely, is it, Sal?
Oh, I'll change all that when we're married. I'll clear out all this old rubbish and that old armor.
Bung up a nice bit of flowered wallpaper or something.
Yeah, shove in some new furniture, net curtains, bit of linoleum. Oh, Bill will have a lovely motor car.
Not off. Here, you'll be me. Sal, what's an Earl's wife called?
Earless?
Yeah, you'll be the Earless.
Bill, when I'm an Earless, I won't have to work in the fish market no more. You know, I could have my little dress shop. I've always wanted a little dress shop.
Leave it to alcohol, you won't have to work.
I could have me air pearls.
You could have your fingers manacled.
And my toes chocolatized. Oh, and Bill, you'll find me lots of scents.
Of course I will. We'll get rid of that fish smell somehow, girl.
Now, when I smell luscious, we can go to the 3 and 6 penny seats in the cinema instead of the 1 and 3 penny.
Good to dream, isn't it, Sal?
I can't get over it.
Yeah, I've got to be educated.
Educated? Who says?
Who says? What you mean, who says? The executors. That's me aunt and Sir John.
Are they the executors?
Not off. They'll chop off the dough if I don't come up scratch. I got a lot to learn, girl. I gotta work fast. Do a lot of perpetuating.
Oh, yeah? And where'd your walk fit in?
What you mean?
I mean, am I going to be staying here as well?
Well, perhaps you could stay nearby at the pub for a few nights, Sal. That Duchess, she's a bit of a dragon, she is. We'll sort something out.
Bill, all this ain't gonna part us, is it?
What you talking about? Nothing's gonna part me and my girl.
If they made you marry one of their lot, I'd die an old maid.
Yes, Sal. Couldn't live without you.
And I couldn't live without you, Bill.
You're all I got. Life's an empty field. Life can be so awful lonesome.
Thank you.
Somerset, your lordship's butler. May I, on the behalf of the staff, welcome you to Hereford Hall, my lord.
Really, Bill! Bill, he called you my lord.
Oh, no, leave it with me. Thank you very much, thank you. Cheers, Gov. This is Sally.
Pleased to meet you.
Would you care for an aperitif, my lord?
Eh?
Aperitif?
No, thanks, got me on.
Care for a glass of wine, miss?
Here, you haven't got a cigarette, have you?
Cigarettes? Certainly I do.
Oh, gee, Squire.
There you are, sir.
Yeah.
Can Sally have one and all?
Oh, certainly, my lord. Everything here is the property of your lordship, eh? Everything here belongs to your lordship.
Oh.
Sal, take the whole boxful then. Sal, take the bleeding box now.
That's right.
Now, you sure this is mine?
It's all yours, my lord.
Oh, Sal! How about something for your lordship's the matter, girl? What? A comfy chair? Put this in the car, Horace.
Bill, I've always wanted a tote bag, but I am this.
Of course you can. Put this in the Morris, Horace.
Yeah.
put that horse on a diet. It'll take me a week to straighten out these legs here.
Oh, dear, 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 dear.
Here, what's this?
It's beans.
I don't care what it's been. What is it now?
Her Grace believes you're being a bit too convivial with us, my lord.
Too convivial? Well, she's not going to come down here now, is she?
Oh, certainly not. Your lordship is the first member of the family ever to have been down here.
Do what?
It isn't done, my lord.
Oh, blimey. What is the matter with you lot? You all look up at me and the family looks down at me. Here. Hey. I'm in like an amateur sandwich. I think I'll go down to the old rubber dub dub.
The what, sir?
It's a pub. See if my Sally's all right.
Oh, I'm afraid Her Grace doesn't approve of you meeting Miss Sally at the rubber a dub dub.
I don't know. The king never had this much trouble, did he? One quick speech on the wireless, and he and his missus have shot at a lot of them. I know how he felt now.
I owe the people to this. She's going to join
for me. Infamy! Infamy! They've all got the infamy! Yes, I'm seeing rather a lot of you lately.
I thought we might meet this morning, as Mummy has suggested I take you in hand to teach you about art, literature, and life. There's so much I want to show you.
Yes, I can see that.
How familiar are you with the great writers and painters and poets? Do you like Kipling?
I don't know, never kippled.
Bill, you and I are soulmates. I can look deep into your eyes and see what you're thinking.
Then why don't you slap my face?
You're a man.
This is true.
And I'm a woman.
Oh, my God, so you are.
I can see you so clearly now.
Not as clearly as I can, girl.
I'm sailing away with you. I'm abroad.
You certainly are.
Ah, Florence. Beautiful Florence. Just we two, making love.
What, you and Florence?
You kissed me on the piazza.
So I missed.
Oh, Bill. It's useless to resist. Can't you feel my heart pounding?
Oh, Stu, don't start all that. Someone might come in.
Oh, let them come in. Let the whole world come in. What have I got to hide?
Well, there's a thingy.
Oh, Bill, if only you knew how long I've been waiting for you.
Get off. I was only downstairs.
How I looked for someone who plays upon my heart like you.
Thank you.
happy. I'm shocked. I'm astonished. I'm amazed. I'm a startled person.
Oh, Gerald, do you mind?
Yes, I do mind. I'm staggered and jiggered and profoundly disturbed, and I'm going upstairs to bathe my temples in eau de cologne.
Hello, Sal.
Bill, would you have the goodness to present my compliments to Lady Jacqueline and tell her I would like to have converse with you alone?
William, please tell Miss Smith I was just leaving. I detect an odor of prudishness in the room.
The smell to what a ladiness is referring, William, seems to come from some cheap French scent in the neighborhood of that city.
Perhaps Miss Smith is not aware, William, that such gross impertinence betrays her obvious lack of breeding.
Thank a ladyship for me, William, and tell her that if I want lessons in her kind of breeding, I can go to a farm yard.
How dare you! William, I'll see you later when your little friend has gone.
Yeah, that's right, dear. You run off and sew up your dress.
Saucer of milk for Miss Smith, dear.
She don't off get my dander up that one.
I know what you mean, girl. She got mine.
Yeah. How's my girl?
I am fed up staying at the pub, and I don't like coming round here. The Duchess don't want me.
The Duchess? Well, this is my house. If you go, I go.
No, Bill, she's right. As long as I'm around, you can't grow into a gentleman.
Eh?
You'd best forget me.
Forget you? Forget you? I can no more forget you, Sal, than I can forget you.
That's a job in which I take a pride.
You could always make me smile, make my journey seem worthwhile.
Why not keep me always at your side to guide you all my path? No matter what the weather, just you.
Climb that old cherry tree in your father's orchard, I'd throw down all the best fruit for you.
And do you remember how we used to gorge ourselves until we got sick?
Yes, we were very close in those days.
Well, I'm the Earl of Atford. I could have you thrown into the tower, you know. Oh, please put me down.
Well, thank you for dropping by. It's time for some more lessons.
Oh, I was just going down to the pub, see if Sally's all right.
Mariah!
Oh, John, I
John, give a good thwarting.
John, you may leave us. Yes. It is time for some more lessons.
Back to we my kennel.
Oh, John. Yeah. Here you are.
Okay.
Chalk, that's more.
Your Grace.
What's today's torture, then?
I thought we should start with your personal correspondence.
Right! Fair enough! What do they all want now?
Well, this one is from Celia Worthington Worthington, and she wants to know if you lay the foundation stone on the new hospital.
Celia Worthington Worthington? I don't even know it. Know it.
The Worthington Worthington? Why, they're one of the oldest families in England.
Then tell her I'll do it. Do it. Here. They're not older than the Eckards, are they?
No, your family predates them by some 100 years or so.
Up, stop, social climbers, call the news, I'll turn them down. What's this one here?
This is a letter asking if you'll help the old ladies home.
Blimey, I didn't know they were still out. I know this writing right here. This is from my old mate, Bob Barker. Oh, good old Bobby boy, good old Bobby Barking. Here, listen to this, Cedric. Dear my lord, this is to thank you for your wedding present of that bracelet. My missus is very proud of it and wears it on her PTO. Wrist?
No, no, no. PTO. It stands for please turn over.
And wears it on her wrist. We thank you for your invite, but we cannot accept because you are not in our class anymore. Marvelous, isn't it? I'm not in this class anymore. I'm not in your class, Enrico. I'm not in no class. I'm in no class anymore. We moved into a new home near the Gasworks, so there is always a horrible smell from your old pal, Bob.
Well, come along, we have more important things to do.
What do I do in this class, Enrico?
Do you want my advice?
Not Tom.
Very well, Your Grace.
Now, William, I have come to a decision. It is time that local society had a chance to meet you. Tongues have wagged for long enough. To that end, I have issued invitations to a party to be held in honor of your secession.
No, that means my old mate Bob Barking can come.
Oh, no. Yes, it will be only for a select gathering of the county. Oh, right. And now, let us get on with our previous lesson.
Right there.
Good afternoon, Lord Hereford.
Oh, I say, dashing, toodle-pip and all that rot, and going upstairs to bathe my temples in how-do-you-do.
How-do-you-do?
Very well, thank you, how-do-you-do. James, put the rolls in the garage. I'll butter them later. It don't put your neck muscles out talking like this. No wonder the upper classes ain't got no cheese.
Yes, well, speaking like a gentleman is one thing, but behaving like one is quite another.
Yeah.
You've already broken 12 major and 36 minor rules of conduct. Now, here are a few simple don'ts. Don't lie down in my presence. Don't sit while I'm standing. Don't wear your hat indoors. Don't smoke without my permission. Don't have the last button of your waistcoat done up. Don't pick up cigarette ends. Don't put your hands in your pocket. Don't slouch. Don't suck at a bubble that doesn't lose self-control. When you are the host of an evening, you must go out amongst your guests, the life and the soul of the party. Watch me. Ah! Lady Kelsey!
Have a shitty dear. Very
Lord Cheddingham. Lord Cheddingham, I want you to meet Amarilla Lynn. Amarilla, keep your knickers on, girl. For God's sake, you promised me, woman.
Amarilla, tell the bishop alone. Oh, bishop, have you met my fiancée, Sally Smith? She's a real topper.
Oh, Sally, of course, will not be invited to the party. It's vital that you make a good impression.
Knock it. Of course she's coming.
Can't you see that the more you progress, the more inappropriate Sally becomes? She understands that. Why can't you?
Yeah. What have you been saying to her?
Never mind. Suffice it to say that she knows what is best for you.
Whatever you do, you'll never part me from my Sally.
Oh, we'll see about that in due course.
Auntie, my Lady Lynch!
It's more vital than ever that we persuade the Duchess to let William go back to Lambeth.
Oh, he could never go back there now. He started to lock it here.
Oh, but he simply can't stay here. He's an embarrassment to the whole family.
His real roots are here, not in Lambeth. If I leave, he'll settle down.
No, he would only follow you. You'll hurt him.
Not if I can think of some way to show him that we're worlds apart. I've got to break it off.
You really are very fond of him, aren't you?
Once you lose your heart, once somebody breaks it, then it isn't yours.
need him.
He's coming.
He'll make us look fools.
Oh, you already look a fool.
He'll make the family look ridiculous.
But he's been schooled. He'll come.
This is frightening.
If he falls down for a pint of beer, I shall scream.
We mustn't lose hope. Have you reorchestrated his table manners? Have you taught him not to whistle? Have you shown him?
Earl of Hanford!
Ah! Aunt Maria! Gosh, you look so absolutely ravishing. Welcome to Hanford Hall, everyone! Dash it!
Oh, who's that?
William!
Good now!
Anytime you're laughing, any evening, any day, find us all.
trying to get William to run away with her.
Hey, I thought you wanted him to stay here.
Oh, Gerald, you really don't know anything about women.
I may not know anything about women, but, Dasha Jackie, I like you.
She's clever, very clever. She knows that if she plays the little martyr, William will want her all the more. Gerald, do you mind?
Sorry.
Money must get rid of her.
Shot!
Gerald, come and have a drop of Rosie Lee.
Thank you. This is coffee.
That's right, coffee, yes.
But I thought that Rosie Lee was rhyming slang for cup of tea.
Ah, but this is blank rhyming slang.
Blank rhyming slang?
Yes, modern poets these days write in blank verse. Verse that doesn't rhyme. This is blank rhyming slang. Cain and Abel, chair, that sort of thing.
Man, he's driving a hell of a stalk standing man. The sooner he barely goes, the very better.
Thank you for coming out, Sally. I wanted to speak to you before you return to Lamford. You know that it's quite impossible for William to return to Lamford with you.
Of course I do. What do you think I was trying to show him last night?
Mariah, you can't still be.
Oh, hush, you futile man. I appreciated what you tried to do. Unfortunately, it had the opposite effect. Therefore, you must go to Bill and...
Mariah, it crossed my mind.
Not a long journey. You must go to Bill and break it off, finally, once and for all. Tell him you no longer love him.
But even if I leave him, he'll only follow me. You heard what he said.
I think you could stop him from following you if you really wanted to. But if not...
Yes, I know. Well, I won't spoil his chances. He means too much to me for that.
Well, you won't find him in the library.
What's he doing there?
I have persuaded him that he must make his maiden speech in the House of Lords.
Yes, as a peer of the realm, he has to appear in the robes and coronet of an earl and make a maiden speech.
Blimey, whatever is he going to speak on?
With a public right of way bill of 1826.
And after you have spoken to him, I will give orders to have the car take you away to London. Make sure he has no intention of following you.
You're a wicked, interfering old bat.
I'm impervious to flattery.
Your Grace.
You can't do this to your...
But she's right. Bill belongs here. I don't.
But you must stand up to her. You must show her who's boss.
She already knows who's boss. She is.
Leave it to me. I'll tell the old witch.
Witch!
Witch reminds me my shop.
What's the matter? Are you crying?
Family round about. Then my father said, and my mother said, and my sister said, and my brother said, there's one little thing you should certainly know. When into the world you go, take your troubles on the chin, and then you get an earful. Don't despair or tear your hair, for heaven's sake, keep cheerful. That's what father said, that's what mother said, that's what sister said, but brother said they were certainly right to tell you so. I think that you should know. Thank you.
Lordships. Your Lordships, your warships, your fish and chips. My noble lords, I rise to my feet on this suspicious occasion. And having risen to my feet, ogle!
Press up, Sal.
And you dropped your coronet.
Oh, that's a coronet.
Yeah. You don't often look smart, Bill.
Do you reckon?
But why is your getup all trimmed with vermin like that?
Vermin? This, my girl, is ermine.
Well, those look more like vermin.
Yeah, they do it all, don't they?
Bill, what's this book said?
Oh, that is the history of the Affords.
Here, Sal, put that down. That's my family tree.
It's got pictures of all my ancestors from 1066.
Oh, yeah, I learned all that when I was at school.
Then you know who invaded Britain in 1066?
Of course, the Romans.
Nah, the Romans come over in BBC. I'm talking about 1066 Anno Dominos, the Battle of Hastings, when Harold was hit in the hive. With a harrow.
Oh, yeah, I remember now. He put an apple on his head and said, shoot, Father, I am not afraid.
No, Sal, you're thinking of George Washington and the cherry tree.
Sal, you're standing on your cloak.
Oh, thank you.
No, I'm not. George Washington sat under a cherry tree and discovered gravity.
No, Sal, look, let's sort this whole thing out once and for all. Yeah. We really started with King John, Sally. See that geezer? That Simon Afford. He forced the king to sign the Magna Charta in 1215 and so founded a strong English constitution. Then he married the king's cousin and had 14 sons.
Blimey, he must have had a strong constitution.
And this is him again, forcing him to sign the actual parchment. It ain't working. I'm gonna do this speech, and then you and I are gonna get married and live on the annuity.
I know, dear.
Start that again.
Can't you see why the Duchess has stuffed all these ancestors into your nuts?
to make you feel like a gentleman and me like a worm.
She can't make a sow's purse out of a silk ear.
She's making a gentleman of you, Bill.
Oh, go on.
She's already got you talking like the BBC.
You'll be so bally dog.
And walking like Douglas Fairbanks.
Oh, go on.
You don't even swear, old posh. You've got to marry someone with good blood.
Well, you're not anemic.
It's not true, though. Goodbye, Bill.
Here, Sally. Oh, come on, please, baby. Come on.
I'm not.
Then quit dribbling down on me vermin, then. Here. What? I'll club you with my ancestors right here.
It's no good, Bill.
That does it, Sally. I'm not standing here watching you crying, girl. I'm not having this. I'm gonna sort it out with her once and for all.
You'll never stand up to a Bill.
Won't I? We'll see about that.
Put that down.
Oh, I already am. Now I'm ready for her.
Thank you.
is here. Oh, a right girl, bloody knees right over here.
Oh, good God. But you must be as drunk as I am. It's the only way with Mariah. She's just like Mussolini, but without the charm.
Oh, God.
Ah, thank you, Hellaset. Tea? How dare you? I had half once the drunk tea did before she saw 50. Mind you, the steam roller didn't help matters. But come on, my boy. Let's get squiffy.
John, she's trying to turn me into a novel.
A what?
Talking to those hermit like you. No.
None taken, dear fellow. You're very good help.
So are you, John. So are you.
Extraordinary. You know, when I first saw you, I said to myself, Johnny. I always call myself Johnny. Well, that's my name, you understand? Johnny, I said, this man standing here is a snuffergipe. I think you mean gunnersnipe. This man I would walk a mile in tight shoes to avoid. He is an unmitigated yahoo.
That is the nicest thing that anybody has ever said to me. Here you are, my son.
Oh, Charlie! Do that!
Here, Johnny, let's have another drink.
Water me, old cock.
Here, don't you let that old bat like hear you talking like that, Squire. It won't have to be a lot of trouble. My Sally catches me drinking this much. Lots of them.
Bill, yeah. The Duchess is the key. We've got to get the Duchess to see Sally in her true light.
If I may suggest,
where the devil did he come from?
You must both stand up to her. Tell her, if I may use the phrase, where to go.
With knobs on.
You and our side, Cedric.
Cedric? Is that your name? Well, I never knew you had a name. My, what short arms you have. What, just
Cedric.
Hell, corpse. In this battle, you are either with us or you are not with us.
It's one for all. And all for one.
And I'm for another drink.
Yeah, me and all.
Then I suppose I must be with you. We shall present a united front.
So what do you advise then, Cedric?
You and the family demand. Well, let me tell you something. We. I demand that I marry Sally or die an old maid.
Come, pull yourself together and come here.
I won't come here.
Come here.
Stop.
Oh, listen to me.
No, you listen to me. You and the family cannot go to Blazes. And he told me to tell you so. And what's more, Sir John told me to tell you to all go to Blazes and then the fat will be in a fire.
The history of the Airfords begins with me. And this is what I think of your family history right here.
Oh, how dare you! Well, this proves just how much you need a fit and proper wife to teach you how to behave. Sally, oh, she is the last one for that position. Finally, and positively the last!
Bill! I just saw Sally leaving in the car.
It's her. She's made her go back to Lambeth's.
I'll get Mariah back. I'll show her it's wrong to part two lovers. I'll stand up to her.
Johnny, I want to tell you something. Oh? You know, Sally, she's my girl. I've never loved anybody else. Well, you know, except you, of course.
Of course.
She means everything in the world to me.
Me too. She's a hard old battleship. But I love her.
What, Sally?
Yeah, Mariah.
Yeah, Johnny, why's everything spinning round? What have you done to this room, you little rascal?
Not me, old boy. Must be something to do with sunspots. What the devil is making everything go
right now?
The world keeps on tuning. You can't stop it tuning for long.
Thank you.
off for me?
Good luck, Sally.
Oh, my, but what a good judge of character. Some other time, perhaps.
Pardon me, sir. Can you tell me where I can find number 21?
Capstan Street.
For your information, sir, you're in Capstan Street, even as you ask. And by a further stretch of coincidence, you'll find yourself immediately outside of 21.
Well, thank you, officer.
Not at all, sir. It gives me great satisfaction to be of service to you. It is my function, and I perform it with zeal.
Thank you very much, officer. Dormez bien.
Merci bien, monsieur. Bonsoir et bonne.
Good Lord, an educated policeman. What next, a polite cabbie?
Ah, here we are.
Number 21.
Yes?
Good evening, madam. Does Miss Sally Smith live here?
He wants her.
Well, say it's her fairy godfather.
Eru?
Here, look, just take me into her.
Now, 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 you damn not. Don't you filthy beast. Sally! There's someone to see you.
Who is it?
Oh, he says he's your funny godfather.
Silly, not funny.
It's all right, Sally. It's only me.
Coming. So, John, what you doing here? Oh, it's all right, Mrs. Brown. This is a very dear friend of mine.
Oh, I'm sure. This is what comes of hobnobbing with the gentry.
Good night, fair spirit of morality. Now then, Sally, we'll talk.
It's no good, Sir John. I'm going to move away. I'm not going back. You're wasting your time.
I didn't come here to persuade you to go back.
You haven't?
No, we must beat the Duchess at her own game.
The Duchess don't like me for not fitting proper.
Ah, but suppose we made you fit and proper?
Get away. Besides, I wouldn't want it.
Oh, it wouldn't do any harm. There are all sorts of things you can do with a good accent. Gerald has made a profession of it for years. And what about McCaddy Grant?
Yeah, I'll go get my little dress shop. You know, I've always wanted to do that. But how would you do it?
Ah, not me, but an old army friend of mine shares a house on Upper Wimpole Street with a remarkable man who could certainly do it. Matter of fact, he's done it before. If you love Bill, you'll let him try.
Only if you promise not to tell Bill where I am.
I promise.
Then we'd better go straight away. Because look.
I'll give my friend a call.
Good. I'll run in and pack a few things.
Good girl. My car's just the end of the street.
Okay.
Ow! Oh, dear. I must have dropped something.
A couple of eaves, perhaps.
Sam, what if I was listening? It was for Sally's own good.
So you're Mrs. Brown?
Yes. Mrs. Anastasia Brown.
Well, Mrs. Anastasia Brown, evidently you heard that I'm going to take Sally away.
Oh, I heard the fairy tales you were telling the poor mite.
Then you also heard that she doesn't want Bill to know where she's gone.
Oh, neither do you, I don't suppose.
Do you know what this is, Mrs. Brown?
Well, it sounds like a fiver.
Does it look like a fiver?
Oh, it is a £5 note.
Well done, Mrs. Brown. Here you are.
Oh, thank you, sir.
And there's more where that came from if you keep your mouth shut when Bill comes for Sally.
Oh, I get you, sir. Mum's the word.
Good girl. Tell Sally I'll be waiting her in the car. Ah, not tonight, my dear. It's war, and I must rejoin my regiment.
Why, I'd know that face anywhere.
Oh, my lord.
Oh, now, don't start, Mrs. B. Where's Sal? She in?
Oh, she's gone. Went away.
What you mean, gone?
Oh, she went away. She didn't say. She's not coming back no more.
When?
Oh, ages ago.
She get my wire?
Oh, yes. No, I mean, that's what they have got.
Leave an address?
Oh, no address.
What's about a mail?
Oh, well, she'll collect it. I mean, I don't know.
You're telling me poor Clyde, Mrs.
Oh,
B, she's in here.
No, she ain't. I tell you, she's not.
Oh, yeah? Well, we'll see about that. I'll just wait right over here.
It's no use, Bill. She's not coming back.
Well, we'll see about that.
Come in, sir. I'm off to train you here. Stop me. Come down that heading up on you.
Maybe you think I look attractive. Or you may think I'm watching a girl like that. She's absolutely wonderful and marvelous and beautiful. And anyone can say why. I'm on a lamppost at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes
from.
I didn't realize how fond of Sally Bill is. I thought when she was out of the way that he would, but he's done nothing but suck.
I know. He's just not the same, is he? Still, it's never too late. I knew a couple once who were secretly in love for 30 years.
30 years?
30 years, 7 months and 3 days. Their love was so secret they weren't even aware of it themselves.
And what happened?
Well, they struggled miserably along all that time until one day he took it into his head to get down on one knee, not unlike this, and say in his simple, direct, manly way, I can't move.
I can't move.
My back seized up. Oh. Hit it quick. Harder. Oh. Higher. Ah, there. Damn shrapnel gives me a twinge every time I get worked up. Now then, where the devil was I?
Oh, this couple. The man was about to propose.
Oh, Mariah.
No.
What? Good heavens, Heatherset, you here?
Yes, sir.
Women, Heatherset.
Yes, sir.
Have you ever been married, Heatherset?
No, sir. I've never been married.
Have you ever been in love, Heatherset?
Well, yes, sir. No, I haven't been in love either, sir. I am married.
Ah, well, be that as it may, is she here yet?
Oh, yes, sir. I put her in the bedroom where you told me.
What?
I put her in the bedroom where you told
me. Shh, very good, man. Now remember, not a word to anyone.
Yes, sir.
Is everything going according to plan, Sir John?
Shh. Where's Lord Harefoot?
I believe he's in the bedroom, Mom.
Bedroom? What's he doing?
I believe he's packing, my lady.
Packing? What on earth is he packing for?
I do not know, my lady. He did not confide in me. There, I tell you so.
I'm going to have it out with him once and for all.
Are you not going into his bedroom?
No, perhaps you're right. Heatherset, ask Lord Harefoot to come here, please.
Very good, my lady.
Frankly, Jackie, I think you're making a wit off of yourself for chasing after me hot for all these months. Well, you know, he's done nothing but search for Sally. And even now, when he threatens to go back to Lambeth, still you pretend.
No, still you persist.
I will not persist. I shall carry on until you give up this nonsense and marry me.
Marry you? With all your debt?
Well, as a matter of fact, I don't have any more debt. So a deal was good enough to write me a big check.
Ollie, Ollie! All fresh, ripe strawberries. You rang, madam.
What is the meaning of this? Oh, Mummy.
And what's more, I'm going. Unless the Duchess produces my Sally.
But I
don't know where.
Sally? And what about me? I'm not to be cast aside lightly.
No, you should be thrown with great force.
But don't you feel something when we're together?
I feel ill.
But I thought you cared for me.
I cannot care for you. I'm just an ordinary earl, not a vet.
Let me tell you.
If I were the last man on earth, I'd be too busy to marry anybody.
I say, that was a slap in the face. Would have saved her like it if you slapped her in the face.
It's not her face wants slapping.
Yes, but you do mean.
She'd marry the first man who does.
Really? Mm. Do you think so? Why, I never thought of that. Jackie!
Oh, William! Where do you plan to go?
Back to Lambeth, Auntie.
Oh, but it's madness. It's madness. Oh, but haven't I done enough for you? Haven't I thrown parties for you?
At me.
Oh, but you can't leave now. You must have a son to ensure the succession. Better still have lots of sons.
You got mine like a gerbil.
Oh, but you can't leave now. Not after all I've achieved.
I can't unless you tell me where my Sally is.
Well, I don't know where she is.
Then tomorrow, every picture palace in London will have a newsreel of Lord Hereford going back to Lambeth.
I say, you never guess what's happened. Jackie has promised to be my trouble and strife.
Sorry. Now I'm going back to Lambeth to make Sally be my wife.
And to make the same mistake as your father.
The only mistake my father made was to leave his girl. I shan't. I'm sorry, Auntie. You seem to have lost your little battle.
Well, I hope I'm not ungracious in defeat. You may kiss your auntie?
No, you may kiss your nevy. That's right.
Goodbye, Bill. You're a true Hereford.
Right. Cheerio, everybody. I'm off to finish packing.
Here, Gerald. Run and fetch him back.
Wait, what for?
You'll see.
Miss Sally Smith.
What?
How do you do, your Grace? Lady
Jensen,
such a pleasure.
Yes. I think she's got it.
Where the bloody hell have you been?